should we leave this hungry world? How can we tell which is our place? Leave us alone, you stupid gods. Let us discern what's our fate. Why on earth do we live? Why the hell do we leave? Did anyone decide to be here among us? Has somebody learned why we're stuck?
Thank you. Lass mich meine Qual.
Thank you. Thank you.
There have been very different opinions around the nature of his obsessions. Did he actually suffer from a bipolar disorder? Was it only syphilis? Was it just the heavy drinking? What it always seemed clear, to me at least at a personal level, is that there was something more going on in his head, something that not everybody is able to understand. And everything we have, everything we understand from him is his music, also lots of his texts. By exploring Schumann's life and his work, we have discovered it was not all about struggle. We have worked on his music and experimented the contrast between the deepest pain and also the purest joy.
Thank you.
love interlude where we experience the capacity for the expression of love. We will now come back to the beginning of the journey today. In the year 1854, after trying to attempt suicide, Schumann was admitted to an asylum where he spent the rest of his life. His mind had already been playing on him for a long time, but this time not even Clara, who had been his strongest support and also the reason to stay healthy for so many years, was able to help him. Schumann wrote a concerto, which we first listened today, in only 2 weeks, in October 1850. Other than publishing it, he became obsessed with making corrections. The following years, Clara describes how he was just sleepless. The concerto was staring in his dreams. And at that time, mental diagnosis was even harder than today. And all of his pain and sorrow was the food for his compositions. Can music describe such pain of existence? Would we ever be able to understand what it is to want to live?
This next piece composed as a tribute to Javier Bobet Silvestre speaks about the tragic theme of suicide. In order to do that, it uses various types of musical elements, some of which have a personal connection with the aforementioned young man, such as the quotations from Brahms' Violin Concerto, while others, for example, the descending scale, symbolizes the obsession that weighs down the enjoyment of existence. The constant accompaniment in a sustained rhythm of quarter notes, one each second, is a constant reminder of the implacable tyranny of time. Within this continuous rhythm that accompanies the piece, chords of an impressionistic nature appear throughout the piece, like a blaze of hope interspersed with moments of desperation. In the middle, there is a descending scale, and without warning or prior preparation, the piece concludes abruptly, similar to a life ended too soon.
Nur er die Sehnsucht kennt, weiß, was ich leide. Allein und abgetrennt von aller Freude sehe ich ans Firmament nach jener Seite. Ah, der mich liebt und kennt, ist in der Weite. Es schwindelt mir. Es brennt. Mein Eingeweide. Nur wer die Sehnsucht kennt, weiß, was ich leide.
Thank you.
amazing sweet